the news. Listen to Triple J.
Triple J News. Good morning. I'm Ian Swift. Qantas is investigating what caused the tyres on one of its jets to explode while it was landing in Sydney last night. Stephanie Menezes reports.
The Qantas A380 was coming into land at Sydney Airport when the nose wheel tyres on the plane burst as they hit the tarmac at around 8:30 last night. A Qantas spokeswoman says no one was hurt in the incident. All 244 passengers were taken off the plane once it stopped. Qantas engineers spent last night assessing what had gone wrong with the tyres. It's the second incident involving a Qantas jet in the past 2 days. On Tuesday, a Qantas flight from Singapore was forced to return to Sydney Airport because of engine problems.
The United Nations is urging the international community to support a $4 billion rebuilding plan for earthquake-devastated Haiti. A major donors' conference is being held at the UN. The UN Secretary-General Ban Ki-moon says Haiti's leaders have come up with a concrete, specific and ambitious reconstruction plan.
Our goal is not just to rebuild, it is to build back better. It is a plan to create a new Haiti.
Both the US and the European Union have today pledged more than $1 billion for the rebuilding effort. The Chechen rebel leader, who's claimed responsibility for the double suicide bombings in the Moscow metro, has warned Russia to prepare for more attacks. Doku Umarov, who styles himself as the emir of the Caucasus Emirate, says in a video posted on an unofficial Islamist rebel website that he had personally ordered the attacks. 39 people were killed. A Melbourne man is facing more than 40 charges over allegations he had sex with a number of teenagers he met on the internet. An out-of-sessions court hearing in Victoria has been told that the 24-year-old Frankston man used social networking sites to groom his victims. He was remanded in custody on a range of charges, including 16 counts of rape, 5 counts of stalking, 1 of making a threat to kill, and 1 more of procuring a child pornography. Overseas, a British grandmother has been heavily fined and electronically tagged for selling a goldfish to a child. Pet shop owner Joan Higgins, aged 66, was fined £1,000 and given a dusk-to-dawn curfew for selling an animal to a person under the age of 16. The local council sent a 14-year-old boy to buy a goldfish in a sting operation following reports that the woman's shop, Major's Pets, sold a gerbil to a teenager with learning difficulties. Turning to sports news now, the Australian cricket team will return home from the New Zealand tour today after yesterday's victory in the final test match against the Black Caps. And that's the news for now. Across Australia, here on Triple J.
This is some of Triple J's best news. Birds of Tokyo will wrap up their third album this year. Call it, this is the saddest thing I know. And here's English band Fold with this orange. Triple J.
We love the best new music.
Tom and Alex are in Melbourne laughing their asses off for the Melbourne International Comedy Festival.
Hello.
Hello, yeah. Tom and Alex here. Up from Melbourne for the Melbourne International Comedy Festival, and we're having a right old dapper old Les time.
Good morning to you. Hey, happy April Fool's Day too. First of April. Hilarious pranks. If you know what prank is going on in your local area, text in 1975-7555. We've already had the giant air guitar in Wodonga.
Yeah.
Big sign for new giant air guitar. Queen Street in Melbourne has been changed to Republic Street. Political.
I reckon that could spark a referendum.
Oh.
I think there's rumours of referendum in the air after that one, but this morning on the show. Also talking about lots of funny comedians.
Yeah, Gatsby is going to be concerned. She won Raw Comedy. She beat me in Raw Comedy in 2006. Right. I should punch her.
That's the showdown. Also coming in is Todd Barry and Dead Cat Bounce. Plus, we're going to have some brand new music from Tame Impala coming up very soon.
But very shortly, my dad, Neil Ballard, is going to be on the radio to let you know what he thinks of the feature album this week. It is MGMT's Congratulations. We've been featuring it all week. Of course, you might remember MGMT used to sound something like this. Now, they tend to sound a bit something like this.
Oh,
just gonna let us know.
Oh, now this is a new one from my show. This is great. This is Billie Holiday. Good morning to you, this is Triple J.